Hi everyone, marhaba. This is Shahin and welcome back to another lesson with Globetrot with Arabic. This is a Lebanese Arabic lesson dedicated to my Lebanese Arabic students. And today is day 25 in our 30-day challenge. It's very late at night, but I decided to record a lesson before I sleep so I don't break my promise. Today's lesson is not going to be the happiest lesson because such is life. Sometimes we lose people we love and sometimes we find ourselves in situations where we have to express our condolences to someone. So I thought let's do a lesson about this topic. We can talk about the cultural aspect of death and how people deal with these situations in Lebanon and what are the expressions you can use to express your condolences to someone and how you can say rest in peace in Lebanese Arabic. Let's begin. Let me start by explaining how things happen in Lebanon. So when, God forbid, somebody loses a person, a family member or a friend, within 5 minutes or instantly, the whole house would be full of people. We don't have this understanding of, okay, giving the person the time to get over things on their own. We don't have that. As I said, like within 5 minutes, the whole house would be full of friends, neighbors, family members, the whole community would be there, basically almost the whole country sometimes. And sometimes there would be so many people that it would be difficult to welcome all of them. So neighbors even keep their doors open so that if more people come, they would go and they would sit at the neighbors. There would be lots of chairs. And of course, even neighbors offer coffee and juice and water for the people who are coming to express their condolences. This is something very nice, and at the same time it can be difficult. It really depends on the person and the personality of the person who is suffering the loss, because some people like to deal with things on their own and some people like this sense of community where they feel safe when they have people around them. It depends. But personally, I think this is the nice thing about the Lebanese community, that we still have maybe kind of old-fashioned habits where people are always there for each other. And we have an expression in Arabic that says الناس لبعضة. الناس لبعضة. ناس means people. الناس means the people. لبعضة. لا means for. بعض means each other. لبعضة. الناس لبعضة. The people are for each other, which means people should be there for each other. And this is something very nice. Now, what are the expressions that we use and what can you say to the person? To begin with, the act of going to the funeral or expressing your condolences by going in person or even just calling on the phone is تقديم التعازي. تقديم. تقديم means presenting and تعازي means condolences. التعازي, written as التعازي but pronounced as التعازي, that's the condolences. So تقديم التعازي, that's literally presenting your condolences. Also, when somebody dies in Lebanon, immediately they hang a paper stating that the person is dead. Usually they hang that paper in the church or at the entrance of the house. So there's always this paper that is immediately printed to declare basically the death of a person. I think in English you call it an obituary. In Arabic we call it ورقة نعوي. ورقة نعوي. ورقة means literally a paper or a document, and نعوي means a grieving document basically. But when you put them together, ورقة نعوي, that's not how you say it. You have to pronounce the تاء مربوطة, because ورقة is a feminine word that finishes with the تاء مربوطة. And once you have a noun, in this case which is ورقة, followed by another noun which is نعوي, you have to pronounce the تاء مربوطة. So that's why you say ورقة نعوي and we don't say ورقة نعوي. ورقة نعوي, in English you would say obituary. In Arabic it's like you saying the paper of grieving or the document of grieving, which is basically a declaration of this person being dead. And usually it would have the names of all the family members, whether they are near or far, like close family and more like the extended family, all the names would be in there. Sometimes we can use ورقة نعوي in a funny way. So for example, if a person nags a lot and is very negative and, you know, doesn't see anything positive in life, we can refer to that person as being ورقة نعوي. So if today I'm nagging a lot or something, another person can say to me, شو إنك ورقة نعوي, how, like, you are such a grieving declaration paper, which means you're so negative. So that's ورقة نعوي, ورقة نعوي. Now, a funeral in Arabic is دفن, دفن. Funeral, دفن. When you say دفن or يدفن means you bury, that's why دفن means literally burying, that's why it means funeral. We also have the word جناز. جناز, if you check it, it will be translated as funeral, but it's not really the funeral, at least the way we use it in Lebanon. When we say جناز, it's the ceremony or maybe even the church mass that takes place after 40 days the person dies. So if you go to a funeral because the person has just died and they're burying him, that's دفن. But 40 days later, when they have another mass, that's جناز, جناز. And sometimes we use the expression جناز الأربعين. أربعين means 40. الأربعين means the 40. And جناز الأربعين means the funeral of the 40. So جناز الأربعين. And sometimes we even refer to it just as الأربعين, which means the 40, الأربعين. Initially I used تقديم التعازي, but I can also say, for example, if I'm going to a funeral, I say عندي عزا, I have a funeral, عندي عزا. And عزا means condoling someone. Now, how can you express your condolences basically? You can say بقدم لك أحر التعازي, بقدم لك, بقدم is I present, بقدم لك, literally you're saying I present to you or for you, بقدم لك أحر التعازي. أحر means the warmest and تعازي means condolences. This is a bit formal, we don't really say it in Lebanese Arabic, but in Arabic culture you might hear it, especially if you're reading a formal document or something, you might hear بقدم لك, or it would be written as أقدم لك, أقدم لك أحر التعازي. If you want to translate that into Lebanese, you would say بقدم لك, I present to you أحر التعازي, the warmest condolences. Now, to say rest in peace, we say الله يرحمه if it's a man who died, and الله يرحمه if it's a woman. Again, الله يرحمه or الله يرحمه. Now, الله يرحمه literally means God literally mercies him, which means may God have mercy on him, Allah يرحمه. And if it's a woman, Allah يرحمه. Again, يرحم means, in Arabic you don't say to have mercy, you say to mercy. So may God mercy her, Allah يرحمه. So that's the way we say rest in peace in Lebanese Arabic, and also in other Arabic countries, not just in Lebanese Arabic. Now, another expression you can use is نفسه بالسماء, or if it's a woman who died, you can say نفسه, نفسه بالسماء, نفسه بالسماء, or نفسه بالسماء. سماء means literally the sky. بالسماء means in the sky, and نفس in this context means the soul. Okay, so نفسه بالسماء, or its spirit basically, the spirit is in the sky. نفسه بالسماء, his spirit is in the sky, or may his spirit be in the sky. And نفسه بالسماء, her spirit is in the sky, or may her spirit be in the sky. A very, very common expression also that we use in Lebanon when somebody passes away, if we're talking to the whole family, we say العود بسلامتكن, العود بسلامتكن, العود بسلامتكن. Now, what does this literally mean? When you say العود, عود, يعود is a verb which means to make up for. عود in the past, يعود in the present. Now, عود is the making up for, so it's a noun. العود, العود بسلامتكن, العود بسلامتكن means the making up, literally, in your plural, safety or health. It's a way to say may your loss be made up through your health or through your safety. العود بسلامتكن, if you're talking to a group of people. If you're talking to one person who is a man, you would say العود بسلامتك, العود بسلامتك. May your safety be the making up of your loss, basically. So alawat bislimtak, that's if it's a man, and if you're talking to a woman, you would say alawat bislimtik, alawat bislimtik. So alawat bislimtak, alawat bislimtik, and if you're talking to the whole family, you would say alawat bislimtkun. There are other expressions that you can use, and these expressions are not necessarily only used when it's a funeral. It can be another occasion when you're wishing well to someone. So for example, if I say la'awad bislimtak to someone, maybe they can reply and say Allah yikhalli lik a'iltik, because I'm a woman. Allah yikhalli lik a'iltik. If they're talking to a man, they would say Allah yikhalli lak a'iltak. Allah yikhalli lik a'iltik, or Allah yikhalli lak a'iltak, which means literally, may God keep your family. Allah, God, yikhalli, he keeps, yikhalli lak. So we're not going to pronounce it yikhalli lak in this case, no, because we're adding the lak. So yikhalli on its own, but yikhalli lak, keep for you, basically. Allah yikhalli lak a'iltak. If it's a man, the ak in the end makes it your. And if it's feminine, you would say Allah yikhalli lik a'iltik. We can also say Allah yikhalli lak mahabbinak. May God keep or protect, basically, your loved ones. Mahabbinak. Allah yikhalli lak mahabbinak. Mahabbin. Mahabbinak. That's if you're talking to a man, and if you're talking to a woman, you would say Allah yikhalli lik mahabbinak, Allah yikhalli lak mahabbinak, and Allah yikhalli lik mahabbinak. There are other expressions that are also commonly used in standard Arabic specifically, and in other Arabic countries too. So I thought I can teach you these as well, because it depends also on the culture you come from in Lebanon. It even depends on your religion and on your religious background. Different people use different expressions. So these are expressions, of course, anyone can use, but there are maybe probably people who prefer to use some expressions more than others. I cannot really define who uses what 100%, but you can of course use any of these wherever you find yourself, whether you're in a Christian community in Lebanon, whether you're in a Muslim community in Lebanon, it doesn't matter, you can use all of these. So one of the expressions is in standard Arabic, and it says al-baqa lillah, al-baqa lillah. Al-baqa literally means staying or remaining. Lillah means literally for God. So when you say al-baqa lillah, it means our stay or us remaining here on this planet is God's decision, basically. God decides when we stay and when we leave. So that's when you comfort someone and you tell them al-baqa lillah. It's a way to say, you know, we're all gonna die and this is not something in our hands. So that's al-baqa lillah. It doesn't change whether the person who died is a male or a female, or when you're talking to a man or a woman, it doesn't matter. It's a fixed expression, al-baqa lillah. The other expression is inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Let me repeat. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. It's standard Arabic, but it doesn't mean you can only use it in standard Arabic. You can use it in many spoken Arabic dialects or contexts. So inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Inna means we are. Lillah literally for God. Allah means God. Lillah means for God. Inna lillah wa inna, and we are, ilayhi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, and we to him, ilayhi raji'un, returning. We are for God, and for God we return. Inna lillah wa inna ilayhi raji'un. It's a way to say God made us and God takes away our lives. And finally, the final expression that I want to use today is al-ba'iyya b'hayatak. Al-ba'iyya b'hayatak. And in Egypt they would pronounce it al-ba'iyya b'hayatak. Al-ba'iyya b'hayatak. Al-ba'iyya literally means the remaining or the rest. Al-ba'iyya b'hayatak literally be in hayat, life, hayatak, your life. And if it's a woman, you're talking to a woman, you would say al-ba'iyya b'hayatik. literally the remaining in your life. What does this mean? You know, when a person dies, they lose the years of their lives. It's like you are saying, may the years this person has lost from their lives be added to your lifespan, basically. It's a way to say, may you live a long life. البقية بحياتك or البقية في حياتك. It's a way to say, I offer you my condolences and may your lifespan be long, basically. I think that's it for today. I hope you found it useful and I hope our next lesson will be a happier lesson. And I hope you never ever will have the need to use any of these expressions. See you tomorrow. Bye.